天下没白吃的午餐，每样东西都有价，就连参加电视节目被天上掉下来的礼物砸到。或是祖上积德，相信好人有好报的幸运参赛者。也会很快收到国税局寄来的高额税单，以及伴随奖品而来的各种费用。看起来不要钱的东西，其实还是要钱。这个颠扑不破的原则，古往今来皆然，放诸四海皆准。却在20204月20号这一天，被国际原油价格似乎给一举贯破。因为在这一天，美国 WTI 五月原油价格在期货交易所看板上出现了-$37.63收盘价，也就是说，当天买油的人不但一块钱不必给，甚至可以从卖家那里收到每桶$37.63白花花的现金。如此完全颠覆买卖意涵、翻转市场观念的异常现象，不止惊呆了原本对石油市场不甚熟悉的一般大众，更令能源业与期货市场的资深老鸟摇头长叹：活了一辈子没见过这种。
Well, today was probably one of the most historic days we've ever seen on the CME or NYMEX, with prices falling as low as -35, -40. Crude has never gone negative. And today we went negative in a major way. And again, this one, I think, is one of the most historic days since crude started trading back in the early 80s.
The oil prices have turned negative. The most extraordinary development that took place today when the U.S. main blend, West Texas Intermediate, fell more than 306%. You see it on the screen. It is -$37.63 a barrel. That means producers are paying to get rid of the oil. How can the oil trading contract be negative?
Well, it's a once-in-a-lifetime event, Richard. As you were suggesting here, those who are holding the physical oil are willing to pay others to take it off their hands.
由于新冠疫情夺走了世界各地人们的行动自由和衍生能源需求，原油市场疲弱的基本面早已在三月初油价暴跌和股市崩盘中清楚地展现出来。但从年初每桶$60到三月中$25上下，到上周五$18，再到负油价，原油价格如自由落体的坠落曲线，违背了物理定律，更不符合市场常态。是绝不可能只靠基本面疲软一句话就能解释，异常现象的背后必有异常因素，而今日油市中的异常因素就是油太多，多到没地方放，多到你想送人都没人要。
30 million barrels of oil is the surplus that we have right now, but 10 million barrels is what's cut. So there's 20 extra million barrels just sloshing around with no place to go. All the storage is filled up. And when all the storage is filled up, there's nobody who wants the oil. In fact, you've got to pay people to take it away. And that's what you saw today in the spot markets and crude.
以脱口秀节目的汽车大放送为例，如果欧普拉和艾伦在节目上宣布他们要送的不是最新款房车，而是一辆18轮连接大卡车，由于法规要求大卡车驾驶人必须取得特殊职业驾照，同时还要自备能够停放连接车辆的大型停车场，那么或许你已经能够想象现场观众听到连接车三个字脸上表情的变化。同样的道理可以用来解释20号原油期货市场上的戏剧性走势。由于期货市场大部分的交易人都是没有储油设施，也没有炼油执照的一般法人或散户，当五月原油期货即将在一天后，也就是4月21号到期，必须进行现货交割手续，也就是实际上的把一桶桶原油交货给期货合约持有人时，依照过去正常的做法，法人或散户会把 把合约卖给真正有现货需求、可以操作石油业务的石油业者。但在疫情重创原油需求面、全球储油设施又近乎满槽的极度异常状况下，投资人发现自己挂出去已经是赔本的价格，竟然吸引不到任何买家上门。无奈之下，一路砍价，一直砍到零元以下，也就是倒过来贴钱给买家，才有人愿意出面承接。
And when the contract closes, like you got to deliver the oil and actually like a specific place. This is West Texas crude, so it's got to go to Oklahoma. So there's actually like a bottleneck. Like you just don't. There's not the space to like offload all this oil.
Right. The futures market, as you know, is a financial system. So, you know, money changes hands. But when we get to this end of time, when the contract is actually due, we've got to turn this into real physical oil. And that changes the game entirely. And you need to have people who actually take it or are going to deliver it. And right now, nobody will take it.
Thank you very much, everyone. Based on the record low price of oil that you've been seeing, it's at a level that's...Very interesting to a lot of people. We're filling up our national petroleum reserves, strategic, you know, the strategic reserves. This is a great time to buy oil. And we'd like to have Congress approve it so that we could, instead of just storing it for the big, usually the big companies, because I think we have 75 million gallons right now capacity. That's a lot.
油价崩盘越演越烈，可能危及整个石油产业根基和长远的发展。美国总统川普上个月出面倡议由美国战略石油储备出面承接市场无人承接的低价原油，一方面可以逢低买入，节省联邦购油预算，另一方面也能够疏解石油上下游产业链在这个节骨眼上无处存油的燃眉之急。但此一做法却遭到美国国会以有图利声名狼藉的大型石油公司之嫌予以封杀，排除在疫情纾困方案之外。虽然川普仍然打算寻其他管道，像是以行政命令拨用可支应预算，或是出借油槽给石油业者来协助产业渡过难关，但平心而论，多数业界人士坦承，政府介入顶多就一时。以目前评估疫情可能延烧至夏季甚至更久的预测来看，想要化解这场石油危机，唯一的解决方就是顺应需求面的崩跌，即刻大幅减产。
Why don't they just switch the pumps off?
It's not quite that simple. I'll tell you that a lot of what's going on right now is they are trying to kill wells, they are trying to shut in wells. But normally when there's an oil bust, people stop drilling and they wait for the well decline curves to kick in. It's really destructive to shut in a well.
You have each oil well and each head that's pumping out the stuff.What happens if you just turn the tap off for 3 months until the market gets better?
Well, it's not so simple as that. You have to use chemicals. You have to understand the pressures that are involved. And you can, but you're in a lot of situations, you're not just shutting the tap off, you're killing the well. So an oil company has paid $5 million, $10 million for this hole in the ground, and you're going to have to pay to shut it off completely. So you're likely shutting it off for its economic life.Not just turning the tap off, and so that's why companies were reluctant to do this.
虽然副油价只是昙花一现，美国原油期货在第二天21号随即反弹，回到了正常的正价位。但在基本面疫情疑虑无从消除，随时有可能挤压技术面，再度爆发储油设施不足等异常因素，不定时突击原油价格的暗淡前景中，石油产业的减薪、资遣、倒闭潮已经从俄语转变为现实。而当环环相扣的现代经济体系崩塌了。基底的能源一角，其他的产业、其他人还能自外于这一场石油危机多久的时间？没有人敢乐观。
Think about automobiles, for example, Chris. I mean, if you have 20% unemployment and, you know, automobiles, you know, millions, 15, 20 million of them are leases, how many of those leases are going to get thrown back at the banks? And what are the banks going to do with all these cars? And cars prices are going to crater. And nobody's going to be able to sell a car. Nobody in this country wants to buy a car. There's going to be tremendous pressure on banks that have all of these loans basically that they're getting back with cars that have very little value. They're going to see cars go down the way crude did, closer to zero. And this, you know, reverberates in a thousand different ways where we could call, you know, any commodity, not just oil, you know, as being a victim of this this virus and the cratering that's going on in the global economy. So I just don't believe that we've seen anywhere near the worst of all of this. And I think oil is telling that story right now.